The degree show is nearly over. But first, live from just outside the O2, it's the award show 2016. Ladies and gentlemen, you've heard him on your telebox. You've listened to him on your wireless. Now, he's here for you tonight, live. Please welcome your host for this evening, me.
It's me. Look at you lot. Keep it going, keep it going. Have a quick selfie, have a quick selfie. Yes, it's me, ladies and gentlemen. Keep your applause going. No, please don't. Don't stop. Well, there's nothing like a low-key, understated entrance, is there? And that was nothing like a low-key, understated entrance. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I am Rachel Adedeji. Boom. Get in. No, I'm Peter Dickson. But I am the voice of the X Factor, ladies and gentlemen, yes. Thank you. A few fans over here. Not so many over there. We'll get to you later on, don't worry. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm also the voice of Britain's Got Talent, All-Star Family Fortunes, Mr. and Mrs. Live at the Apollo, the Channel 4 Comedy Gala, Comic Relief, Soccer Relief, any old relief. Anyway, you get the picture. Can I just say, before we begin tonight, what a great... honour and indeed privilege it is for you to have me here tonight with you. Now, having said that, I'm not a stand-up comedian. I don't have any material as such, but I find, you know, when you're a bit of a looker, it doesn't really matter, you know. It's all on telly. But tonight, seriously, ladies and gentlemen, it's all about you lot and you lot up here. And many of you, many of you in this room tonight and watching on TV will have experienced disappointment at some point in your life. And many of you are going to feel it again in the next hour because, let's face it, not everyone can be a winner. So if you're sitting at the back, way over there, or way over there, or even if you're up here, I wouldn't get your hopes up too much, really. Let's just put it that way. What I'd do, really, is... just order another bottle of wine and let nature take its course, all right? So anyway, ladies and gentlemen, are we all ready to do this thing? Come on, let's get some atmosphere going. Good, that's where we want to hear that enthusiasm through the show. These students who have graduated today, and I believe some of you have got your results already, which is great. So I don't have the results come in yet. Some have. So there are a few happy faces and a few not so happy faces, but you've all graduated, which is great. And we're going to be rewarding and awarding the very creme de la creme, the best of you, tonight at this very special event, which is going out. You're all on TV, by the way. This is going out live on TV and on YouTube. So sit up straight. Make sure you're sitting with someone that you want to be sitting with or shouldn't be sitting with, because that's happened before, believe me. So let's get this show started, ladies and gentlemen. Please welcome to the stage this year's degree show producer, Mr. Jack Brown. Here he is.
Well, good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the award show 2016. Firstly, thank you all for being here tonight, and huge congratulations to all of our nominees. It's been such an honour and a privilege being the event producer for this year, and over the last 6 months, myself and the team have been working hard to push limits and showcase the degree show like never before. In this role, I have learnt so much. I've learnt the importance and value of teamwork. I have learned that anything is possible if you put your mind to it. And finally, I've learned that I don't want to see another cheerleader again for a very long time. I would also like to take this opportunity to say a couple of thank yous. Thank you to all of our sponsors who have helped make the degree show possible. Thank you to Jenny, Louise, and Asha for being brilliant mentors and for trusting me in this position. Thank you to Claire, Lauren, Charlie, and Ruth for their continued help and support. Thank you to Martin and Richard for all of their assistance in getting us on air. Thank you to my course leader, Steve, for giving me the time to concentrate on the degree show. Steve, I promise you, I'm all yours next year, all right? Thank you to Ian for giving me my first gig of working within the institution and for believing in me from the very start. Thank you also to my amazing team of over 100 people who have just blown me away with their dedication and talents. And special thanks to Tom, Dan, and Georgia for making tonight so special. Georgia, we did it. And finally, thank you to Ravensbourne for giving me a purpose, for igniting my passion for this industry, and for just being the best place ever. Now, let's take a look back at some of the highlights from the last 3 days. Thank you very much, everyone.
Well, it certainly looks like you lot have been very busy, and of course, all this wouldn't have been possible without great leadership. And on that note, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce Ravensbourne's director, Professor Linda Drew.
Thank you very much for the kind introduction, Peter. It's a real delight to have you here with us tonight, and particularly as well you, our honour guests, our partners, our sponsors, alumni, governors, staff, family, friends, and of course our wonderful and beautiful students. Welcome to the 2016 awards ceremony, the culmination of our degree show, and it's going to be a fantastic evening, I think you'll agree. So tonight's very much about our students, their hard work, and their achievement. I've had the pleasure over the last 3 days of seeing all this amazing work of our students, and I have to say, our reputation is in excellent hands. Thanks very much. So now, no ceremony would be complete if we didn't say thank you, and I'd like to say a number of thank yous today. So thank you to our sponsors, particularly to Ogilvy, to the O2, to Stage Electrics, Lavo, Camera Corps, Gearhouse, EVS, Aspect Press, Small Business Centre, and Peachy Productions. Of course, thanks to our entertainment for tonight, that's Holly Brewer, Corey Fox Fardell, and 29 Fingers. I haven't counted all of them, but a huge thanks to the Grease Show team. And I can't name all of them. I know that Jack said there's over 100 of them. There's so many of them. But I will name some specific people, and my specific thanks go to Jack Brown, the show producer, and his team members who've been absolutely brilliant over not just the last few days, but for the past few months. And that's Richard, Luke, Jess, Andrew, Kieran, and Valerie. The students have been supported by a lot of our staff, but I'm going to mention some of the names of our staff that have been particularly brilliant, particularly Louise Prideaux, Martin Gates, Richard Manning, Claire Selby, Jenny Stewart, Jackie Miller, and Jim Valentine. You've been stars. So well done to you all, because particularly you symbolise the values of Ravensbourne. Thank you. It has been another amazing year. This is only my second year at Ravensbourne, but I've been blown away. We've really been recognised from some amazing things through awards and accolades. And although there's a very long list, which I won't bore you with, that is such a long list because I've actually seen it and I know the kinds of things that I'd like to let you know about. But I'll give you a few highlights. Earlier this year, we were particularly proud to win the National Undergraduate Employability Awards 2016 for our collaboration with Ogilvy and the Rough Diamond Talent Programme. Very proud of that. This year, Ravensbourne also became the first institution in the UK to partner with Material Connection. That's a global materials consultancy in the US. So we've opened the first materials library in the country. And it's quite spectacular. So if you get a chance, go and see it. Next week, Ravensbourne Student Services team will be attending what we call the Higher Education Oscars. They are known as the Thelmas. I won't spell that out for you, but it's Higher Education Leadership and Management. Because our Student Services team have been nominated for really outstanding services to students, and we know they do that. So even if we don't win, I think it's a great achievement to have been nominated. So best of luck to all of them. It's a great achievement. And it's been a great year for our students too. I want to tell you about some of those achievements, particularly for our fashion students. They worked on a fantastic project called Couture in Orbit, a special space-themed show in collaboration with the Science Museum that included undergraduate, postgraduate, and incubation companies. That was with the European Space Agency. We were one of five of the institutions that were picked, the only institution from the UK, all the other institutions from other parts of Europe. We worked on this project together with those other European institutions. And as part of that, as a kind of part of cheering on our students received a special message from Tim Peake from the space station. To get a message from outer space, I think that's quite amazing. We've also had some other successes in digital advertising and design. Dan Purdy and Cindy Tonito exhibited in the Miller Learning Room at the Queen's Gallery. Now, some of you might not have been there. That's at Buckingham Palace. They want to widen their audience, so they worked with our students, and they worked on successfully pitching their ideas to the Royal Collection Trust. And Alice and Victoria Geary, who are both BA animation students, also worked with BBC Radio 4, and I know we have them in the audience. They worked on the animation for British History and Weather, which, if you haven't seen it yet, go to Radio 4's website. There's some really gorgeous illustration and animations there, and they're very, very enjoyable to watch. But let's not forget, there's something amazing going on tonight as well, just as I'm speaking. Our students are helping the Tate Modern to visualise their new extension. I think it's amazing. I think we're going to try and get a bit of a live link to them later if we can. If not, we'll get James Ward sending us some tweets all the way through to the event. But anyway, I could go on and on. I'm so proud of this of Ravensbourne and all the student work. But we've got a schedule, and I would just like to leave with one thought for tonight, so that we do keep on time. And that thought's from Einstein, who you may not have read, but he did say something which I think really captured my attention. Einstein said, "Only those who attempt the absurd can achieve the impossible." So thank you, and join me in applauding our often absurd but mostly amazing students. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much indeed, Linda. Thank you very much indeed. Ladies and gentlemen, over the past 3 days, students have been showcasing their final projects. And today, our team of judges here at Ravensbourne have had admittedly, the very difficult task of selecting the best students from all of the amazing talent here. Across the 15 courses graduating this year, we have 15 awards categories. For those of you who have not been lucky enough to explore the awards and the show this year, you'll be able to catch a glimpse later on of what has been going on. Now, right now, I'm going to make my Steadicam operator, Joe, walk backwards. This is a lot more difficult than it looks, ladies and gentlemen. It's particularly fraught with danger, so wish him luck as we head over to the table to present our first award. Look at him moving. That's skill, that's training. You don't get... He's no slouch on the Steadicam, I can tell you. For the first time this year, we have a graduating class from digital television production. They're right here. Let's welcome Judge Dr. Gary Pritchard, the Dean of the School of Media, to the stage to introduce the Digital Television Production Award.
Thank you very much. Good evening, everybody. My name is Gary Pritchard. I'm the Dean of the School of Media here at Ravensbourne. And I kind of feel the need to project all of a sudden. I'm projecting. Welcome again. So it's my privilege and honor to actually present the first award tonight, which is for the Digital Television Production Award. Just before I do, can I say I spent a few minutes with judges a little earlier while they were actually in the act of judging. And can I say that some of them literally had their head in their hands, such was the angst of trying to pick winners from the incredible array and talent that we have here at Ravensbourne. So I think you should all be congratulated, so well done for that. So let's run the VT and see who the nominees are.
I actually chose Ravensbourne to do an art foundation, so I've been here for 4 years, and I chose it because I didn't really know which direction I wanted to go in, and Ravensbourne's given me like a good path to follow. It helped me choose exactly where I wanted to be.
I also had a lot of experiences coming through this place. So I worked with the RSC as a broadcast producer for 2 years. I also produced the award show last year for the degree show. So in terms of those type of places, I had a lot of different opportunities coming my way, and also some things from the outside.
It's such an inspiring and motivational place. I feel the moment you step inside, you feel the creativity and the collaboration.
But I think the thing that stands out for Ravensbourne for me is the idea that we all collaborate and we all work together and try and create something that's spectacular.
It doesn't matter ethnic backgrounds, gender, anything, it's relatable. And I think to speak to such a large audience is a special privilege really to get as a career.
And it's a great medium to talk to other people through as well. So if you have a really great idea, television is probably the best way to sort of get your point across.
To engage people, you don't just have a video, it's all the extra content that goes alongside it. We've been lucky enough to work with some incubatees and we've worked with some amazing companies.
Always changing, and it's never kind of like fallen behind, it's always kind of like picked up and changed with the times.
Every mistake at this point in our career, and especially at Ravensbourne, we can definitely learn upon it and build on it. So I'm not really sure to pick out one. I think it just makes us stronger as individuals and as creative professionals.
A live project, and you're trying to put content out, the best content you've ever done. You're trying to show off your work. And all the stress and pressures of time and all the different people that are on your backs. For me personally, and I think for a lot of people on my course, the adrenaline is what makes TV unique.
And the winner of the Digital Television Production Award goes to Bradley Fisher.
Right, I have to apologise how I am right now, but this has been an amazing 3 years at Ravensbourne, okay? Daria here, who was my production manager for my final major project, so she should be up here with me, because it's been absolutely amazing, okay? It's been absolutely amazing. A few people to thank. Obviously my parents. Everyone's going to thank their parents. Beautiful girlfriend Taylor, who's at home watching this. Adam Marshall at the back, who's in the amazing lighting today. Can I just say, you've done an amazing job, my friend. He's been my partner in crime for the past 3 years. So thank you very much, Adam, for all the good times. And just everyone on our course has been absolutely amazing, okay? The content you have created this year has been spectacular. Absolutely amazing. I've seen some amazing projects, had the privilege of editing the trailer. It's been absolutely spectacular, guys. So you should all be proud, and I want to take this home for the whole of DTV, okay? But you have been absolutely amazing. One last thing is that what's special about TV is that it's not just one person. You all collaborate together over the 3 years. It's not one person. You don't just create a project on your own. It's all about collaboration. That's what Ravensbourne is all about. So everyone in this room, collaborate. Really work together, because this university has been the best time of my life, okay? So everyone, be proud of what you create. It is an amazing place, and you should be proud of what you do. Thank you very much, everyone.
Congratulations to Bradley, and well done for managing to hold it together there. I don't know about you, but I'm wrung out already. Marina had our first award. Ladies and gentlemen, our next award is for outstanding achievement in the field of sound design. Or should I say, yes, or should I say, sound design! I hope they had the limiter in there. Ladies and gentlemen, composer Ethan Lewis Maltby was the judge, but as he can't be here tonight with us, Susie Arkley, Senior Director of Partnerships from the O2 Arena, is here to tell us more about the Sonic Sound Award.
Presentation here. Let's take a look at our nominees.
For me, if Ravensbourne was a sound, it would definitely be the old school dial-up tone of the internet, purely because I think that sound represents loads of data being sent everywhere and lots of people talking to each other to create an end product. And just the idea of the dial-up tone is sharing and connecting to a world where you can share and create ideas.
To my FMP, like if you could give everyone in Ravensbourne a speaker, it would be like this amazing, crazy mash of music. But then as you walk past different people, you get these like different colours coming through.
I guess in a world without sound and music, people will try to communicate in other ways. And I think colours and visuals will have a different meaning in people's lives.
Music's the strongest form of magic, so it would certainly be a world with no spark and no magic. And it's a wonderful way of bringing people from different diverse backgrounds.
I created a surround sound experience for music. I basically, instead of like a standard surround sound, you have 5 speakers around a room and a bass, but I created this thing with 8 speakers at different points in the room and no audience space, allowing me to freely, well, the audience to freely walk around the room.
A fantastic short film by Luke Shelley and Michael Kennedy entitled Fear the Unknown Men. It's a Western. Being a Western, it's a fantastic opportunity to show how diverse I can be.
My FMP was purely done with sound, and I hope to convey a real story and give a good impression of characters using just sound and really immerse the audience in the images that they're seeing on screen.
I'll make sure I catch the microphone for this bit. Apologies for my pronunciation. The award goes to Jacopo Consoni.
Well, thank you very much, and I think that I would really love to say thank you to my course leader, my tutors, and my amazing classmates, because I've been learning a lot from them. And also, I would really mention my course rep, Fionn Lucas, who did a lot for our course, and unfortunately he's not here today, but he's great. And also, I would like to end up with a quote from my favorite tutor, David Humphries, which explains what sound is, and that is...
Thank you very much, thanks a lot.
Well, he's very pleased with himself. Congratulations to Jacopo there, and well done. Now, third up this evening is the Fashion Design Award, ladies and gentlemen. Ooh, can I have an ooh? We all like a bit of fashion design. Last week, these students were showcasing their best work at Graduate Fashion Week. Will you please welcome our judge for this award, Zakaria Solomon, to the stage to present the award.
Thank you very much. Good evening. Ravensbourne, thank you very much for giving me this opportunity to be here and be a judge and to give through who the nominees are, the next nominees.
Coming to Ravensbourne allowed me to say, we don't have to fit into fashion. You can create your own trends. And so you don't have to look how people desire for you to look.
In fashion, you need to be able to try and push into something new, because you can spend a lot of time doing the same thing as what everyone's already done before. But being here gives you a bit of a more open mindset to be able to push what you want to do further.
There wasn't really an emphasis to be a particular designer. I quite liked that. As long as you worked hard, then you could do what you want.
In the future of fashion, we'll see clothes and accessories replacing devices and becoming more of a gadget and not just something that looks cool, like it's going to be super functional. I think the wearer, the consumer, will become closer to their materials.
Fashion has a lot to play in, like, kind of politics.
What they choose to wear really singles them out from the crowd of everyone else, and it's a deeply personal thing. My FMP is called Requiem, and it's based on the idea of not looking at fashion through a male or female canon, but looking at fashion through a queer canon.
Well, my FMP is like a science and art project combined. I've grown my own material from mycelium, the root of a mushroom, and I've spent the whole year going between biologists from here in Holland and also trying to, do it myself.
My concept is called Symbiosis Structures. The collection actually explores the marine waters and the symbiosis structures such as the coral reef. At the end of the day, we make fashion and be who we are, and that's how I've seen myself in the last 3 years at Ravensbourne.
And the winner is, can't even read the name. It's Farah Connor.
First of all, I'd like to say thank you for this opportunity today. This award is a contribution back to Ravensbourne University, to Caroline, Julia, Alexa, and the Level 9 technicians who have contributed towards my collection. Also to the free learning resources like lynda.com, where I've been using the 3D application softwares, whilst also contributing a great thank you to all the students who have collaborated with me during the course of my degree. And as a result, and this group collaboration and attaining this award, I'm honored to have had this support during the course of my degree. So thank you.
Well, congratulations to Farah, and thank you, Zacharias. It's nice to see, I feel decidedly underdressed after watching him just now. It's nice to see a man who can wear sandals with such panache and without socks. Which I understand is a fashion faux pas, right? Socks, bad look. Let's now take a little breather here, ladies and gentlemen. It's exciting. Are you enjoying yourselves tonight? Yeah. It's good, isn't it? Let's take a little breather and sit back and relax a little bit as we enjoy some great music from the very talented Holly Brewer.
From all the times that you rain on my parade, and all the clubs you can't and using my name, think you broke my heart, oh boy, for goodness sake. You think I'm crying on my own, well, I ain't. And I didn't want to write a song, cause I didn't want anyone thinking I still care. I don't, but you still hit my phone up. And baby, I've been moving on, and I think you should be something I don't want to hold back. Maybe you should know that my mama don't like you, and she likes everyone. And I never liked to admit that I was wrong. I've been so caught up in my job, didn't see what's going on, and now I know if you like the way you look that much. Oh baby, you should go and love yourself. And if you think that I'm still holding on to something, you should go and love yourself. When you told me that you hated my friends, the only problem, every time you told me my opinion was wrong, and tried to make me forget where I came from. And I didn't want to write a song, cause I didn't want anyone thinking I still care. I don't, but you still hit my phone up. And baby, I've been moving on, and I think you should be something I don't want to hold back. Maybe you know that my mama don't like you, she likes everyone. And I never liked to admit that I was wrong. I've been so caught up in my job, didn't see what's going on, and now I know I'm better sleeping on my own. Cause if you like the way you look that much, oh baby, you should go and love yourself. And if you think that I'm still holding on to something, you should go and love yourself. For all the times that you made me feel small, I fell in love, now I feel nothing at all. Never felt so low when I was vulnerable. Was I a fool to let you break down my walls?
Thank you. Thank you very much. This next one is from Ghost the Musical, actually. It's one of my favourite songs, so I hope you enjoy it. It's called With You. I picked up your shirts this morning. I don't know why. I don't know why. Mr. Reynolds said to say hello. I started to cry. I started to cry. Every place we've ever walked in, everywhere we talked, I miss you. You never leave my mind. So much of you is left behind. You. My nights with you.
those unfinished conversations we used to have still speak to me, and I write you letters every day that I'll never send and you never see. All this wishful thinking gets to me. Nowhere I can stay. Although my heart is broken, it keeps breaking every day. You took my hopes with you. Took my dreams with you. I keep thinking that you'll be calling. Everyone says that it's all in my head, and I can't accept it yet. I'm not ready to just give in. I know that I can
less depressing. It's Ain't No Mountain High Enough.
If you need me, call me, no matter where you are, no matter how far. Just call my name, I'll be there in a hurry.
Ain't no river wide enough. you so much. Thank you. Have a lovely night.
Brilliant. That was brilliant. Not just the design talent on top form tonight, but that was fantastic. Holly Brewer, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, next up, it's the award for product and digital design. Now, yes, there are some product and digital designers here. And unfortunately, our judge, Johnny Spindler, Chief Innovation Officer at AMV BBDO, cannot be here tonight. Very sadly, he has exempted himself. So Louise Prideaux is here to present the award. Louise Prideaux, ladies and gentlemen.
Hello. I was just really honoured about probably 12:30 today to be asked to judge the category of product and digital design. All of the nominees presented their work in such a professional manner. I have had the most difficult afternoon, but really enjoyable and really inspiring. So without further ado, let's have a look at the nominees.
My FMP is to do with cleaning, weirdly enough, because I'm into cleaning. And I really just wanted to make cleaning the household more sustainable and convenient. So basically it takes a kitchen roll and turns it into a cleaning wipe. So this gets rid of the need for cleaning wipes themselves, and they're disposable once you've done the kitchen roll.
The more I got involved, the more the creativity came out. And I think the biggest mistake was thinking it was creative was a learning thing, whereas something that's you need to find, you know, all around you.
To assume that you know what the user wants, whereas from my projects often I do that, and then you find out once you actually go and talk to the user that it's completely opposite. There's always the need for sustainability, so no matter what product it is, plastic, paper, metal, whatever it is, you always have to think about the afterlife of that product and where it's going to end up.
My FMP is a water bottle for hospitals to keep patients hydrated, but it also tracks their hydration, so it gives nurses an accurate measurement of exactly how much you've drank throughout the day.
The reason I think my FMP stands out is because I'm trying to bring the beauty industry further up to date. So I'm creating a service which allows people to check reviews for products all in one place. So instead of a consumer going to four or five websites to check different reviews, you come to my website, you can look at all the reviews in one place.
These days, everybody wants everything faster, they want everything better, and they want everything quicker. And web enables people to do that. Whereas in the past, people were willing to wait 5 minutes for an image to download. Now they want to wait 5 minutes for a movie to download. So it's all about enabling that service, making sure that things are intuitive and that the user enjoys the experience.
I think that's what people really need. They don't care about what other people need. They want personalized and tailored services as well as experiences that are invisible.
So, you can probably see why I had such a difficult afternoon. You can't put a fag paper between them. But there can only be one winner. And for his excellent research, his testing, and his future-facing work that I found really, really inspirational, it gives me great pleasure to announce the winner of product and digital design is Will Jordan.
I don't have anything prepared because the people that were supposed to get this were absolutely incredible, but thank you to all the lecturers, to all the prototype staff, and Louise, sorry, thank you.
Well, brilliant, congratulations to Will. It's going well so far. It's now time for the Concept Award, which incorporates four courses, and here to tell us more is designer and art director Michael Bow.
Thank you. Just want to say a big thanks to Ravensbourne for inviting me back, and I'm very proud of Lumini, and it's been an amazing show, and It'll sound cliched, but it really was so hard to pick a winner out of all the students today. Everyone showed such, you know, a high degree of technical ability and really great ideas. This award is a concept award for creating ideas in their own and individual way. So can we roll the VT?
I chose Ravensbourne because I really liked how it was a college for creatives. The fact that it's in London has really helped me make contacts, and it's given me the opportunity to be able to intern in one of the most fashionable cities of the world.
What will I bring? I will hopefully bring a very fun, disruptive advertising personality. But realistically, what I'll bring is loads of good ideas, loads of design skills, loads of prototyping skills.
I'd like to think that I'd bring a different thought process towards all of design. It's something I generally try to do, but I tend to try and go for different approaches.
So it's just kind of make people happy, make people laugh.
Well, I would say my biggest inspiration, weirdly enough, is my mum.
Probably choose my partner. It's somebody I met on the course about a year and a half ago, and since then she's inspired me throughout just to stick to what my sort of ethics are in terms of design.
She's always created an environment for me as an artist to paint and to create in quite a nurturing environment, and that has always inspired me to do what she does and to just to create.
But if you want to get specific, I don't know, like Wes Anderson, the director, like I love all his stuff. I wanted to do something that was like really simple for my FMP, just because if I did something simple, I could do something potentially like really cool with it. So I'm just talking about like the story of a pen, like the pen has theoretically started everything in someone's life.
It doesn't matter if you're conscious about fashion or not, you still need to wear something, you still need to put something on at the beginning of the day. So I just think it's just something that's subconscious.
I developed an idea to create a London Night Bus Film Festival, and mainly focused on London films and films set in London. So what is different from another film festivals? Then you can experience films watching on the bus when the bus route is linked with the filming locations of films.
For my FMP, I basically spent a week in Athens, Greece. It was a great way to explore and map the city in a different way and learn about areas of the city that I've never been to.
At the moment, I really want to go into film. I still love motion graphics and still love being behind screen and editing, but I love to get involved filming as well. And without my friends inspiring me to do this, I wouldn't have had the chance to do my FMP the way I've done it.
And the winner is Janina Petrolet.
I would like to thank my family to let me come and study here, and I would like to thank my friends Jurati, Giedre, Blaži, Laura, Kelly, Leon for all of help for this all 3 years, and also I would like to thank my tutors, motion graphic tutors Steve, Tim, Paula, Claire, and Liz. Thank you very much for all your advices and help and critique. Thank you, motion graphic.
To Janina, well done. Fantastic. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I've been noticing some of you have been looking at your phones, checking your results coming in. Has anybody done really well? Yes? Not you? Has anybody got a really good degree here? Anybody got? What did you get? A first? Well, I'll read you mine. I got mine. And it's from 1979. 2-2. There's hope for all of us. So anyway, ladies and gentlemen, in case you hadn't noticed, it's not the end of the world. In case you hadn't noticed, we're making a ruddy TV show here tonight, ladies and gentlemen. We've got cameras, lights, sound, a lot of work and planning, as you can tell, has gone into, and equipment, in fact, has gone into the making of this production tonight. And these events just don't happen by themselves. There are a large number of sponsors who have helped you make this show tonight and make it all possible. Let's just take a moment now and see who they are. Give them a huge round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. And I know the students here would like to thank each and every one of those sponsors for helping in the way they did to put this show together and for their wonderful support throughout the year. Well, now we've come to our next award, and this is the Progression Award. It isn't for graduating students, but for those who are completing their foundation courses. Ian Cownley, one of the foundation tutors, is here to tell us what they've been up to, and to announce the winner. Please welcome Ian Cownley.
Hello, everybody. Can I firstly say what a fantastic 3 days this has been? As a foundation student, this award is really important to me because that's how I met Jack. And it's actually how I met a lot of students that are working on this tonight. It's really, really good. And we should be really, really proud that the students that come onto our foundation course and the adult access course stay with us, get good degrees, and then go out and spread the word about why Ravensbourne is a fantastic place. Obviously, I'm on script. I've been told to say that. It's my job. That's what I do in schools and colleges all the time, every single day of the week. But let's get on and look at the nominations from the students from the foundation courses and the adult access courses.
Energy, positivity, passion and hard work is what is key to succeed in the industry today, and I think Ravensbourne has taught me so much in just 1 year when I couldn't even define myself as a fashion student or a fashion designer, and now I feel like one.
My next step, well, I hope to just, you know, dive straight into industry. I feel like I've been dying to study fashion promotion for so long, and having done, you know, this foundation, it's given me the fuel and the energy to go out there and, you know, just get stuck in.
My final major project is a sound piece on sleep paralysis and nightmares. It's essentially like a journey into sleep paralysis.
My FMP is very unusual. I'm working with genetic mutations. The title is The Genetics of Destruction. I've always been fascinated by how things are formed and created and how life comes to be and all the mutations that can be possible. The only way I can do this is if I truly work outside of my comfort zone and do something that will stimulate me and inspire me to push myself even further.
My FMP stands out because it's a really ambitious project and I'm trying to take on many different kind of skills and try and combine them all into one. So whereas I normally just focus on like post-production things, that's what I enjoy. I'm taking on things like costume design and props and stuff like that. So it's a really big, ambitious thing.
My FMP physicalizes anxiety into these tumor-like creatures, which are made out of nylon tights. So they resemble skin. It's representing how anxiety can be this little creature that lives in your head who sort of eats away at your well-being and infects your life.
Make change and just shatter everything and make it be heard, you know? That's what we're here for, the new generation. And I think we're being too passive, so we have to be active and, you know, just make change.
It's
So as you can see, fantastic competition from our internal foundation students. And today, Lucy Slater judged the talent that came forward, and the winner is Reese Nelson.
I'd actually love to say like thank you to the CLR team, because when I because I study fashion promotion, so I'm always booking out cameras, graphic tablets. You guys see me every week, especially up to FMP. It was crazy. Thank you to them. Thank you to my course leader Andrea, everyone that came in, Mark Keane, you know, Mark McMahon, Susie, everyone that helped, and even just thanks to everyone here. I mean, studying in Ravensbourne, it's such a, like, an open community. Everyone can talk, and it's really comfortable and easy to get your work done. So thanks to everyone, especially CLR. Thank you.
Well, congratulations to Reese. Our next award is for contribution to Moving Image. Now, this award focuses on students who create amazing film content for the big screen. We all like a big screen, don't we? I think they do. Philip Richardson has been enjoying their work, and he's here now to let us know what his favourite was.
Good evening. Yes, I'm here to present the contribution to Moving Image Award. Thank you very much, Ravensbourne, for having me. It's been a fantastic night. I've seen a few over my life, and this is a very, very good one. So well done to Ravensbourne and all the students as well. Very good. So let's first of all look at our potential winners and what their work is.
I see Ravensbourne like a family. I think everyone here is really friendly to each other, and they all sit together, they help each other out, and you know, I think even when we all graduate and we leave, we'll always go back to the Ravensbourne people because we know each other best, we know how we work, and it's almost like a big community.
If I could sum up my experience at Ravensbourne in one photo, it would probably be like a big behind the scenes crew photo because of all the amazing people I've met during my time here.
I think that I wouldn't be what I am without everyone else. So I think that they're all inspiring, and that's probably what my picture would be.
The biggest mistake I've made whilst I've been here is not making enough films.
I think if you ever think for 1 second you can't do something, you probably won't do it. But I've always went into stuff head first and always thought, do you know what, screw what people think that might fail, just do it anyway. And I think that's probably the best thing. And
just know what level you're at, and don't think you're better than you are, because it's a big industry and it's very easy to get ahead of yourself. And it's good to tarnish your reputation early, because it's a small world and everyone knows everyone.
I come to Ravensbourne because it seemed like a practical course where you could do more hands-on learning rather than just theory. And that's pretty much what it's brought to me. Like, I've made films and made music videos and met some incredible people that I still work with now. And my FMP stands out, I think, because it's set entirely in a car, so it's really dialogue-based. It's about two police officers and their friendship that grows over some time.
It's a short film about a girl struggling with self-gender feminism. And it's just, you know, raising awareness about feminism in a nice, simple, light-hearted way.
My FMP is a short Western, probably one of the first Westerns at Ravensbourne, so that's pretty exciting. So I needed to do something that would not only prove to myself that I could be ambitious, but also prove to other, so that like other people at the uni, and also to sort of impress the uni and sort of just sort of put my mark on the uni, if that makes sense.
All very good, all very good films. Believe you me, I could barely squeeze a fag packet between them. The winner for beautifully clear, deceptively simple storytelling with a real soul is Charlotte Regan.
Everyone who worked on it, because without them it wouldn't be any good, I don't think, especially the DP Bradley, he's incredible. And all our lecturers, especially Garth, I think everyone agrees he's the most inspiring lecturer we've ever had.
Well, congratulations to Charlotte. Fantastic. Now, great work from the film students, wasn't that fantastic? I mean, we'll see their work in the future, I'm sure, on the big screen, literally. I don't know about you lot, but I need a ruddy break. Should we have a break, 10 minutes? Suits me too. We were back in 10 minutes for the second half, so there's plenty of time to find the loos, have a drink, go for a walk, maybe go for a swim. We'll see you back here in 10. Thank you very much. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back, please. Welcome back and take your seats for the second half of our degree award show tonight. And launching for the first time this year, we have the Incubation Light Award. Now, this award focuses on companies who are all based here out of Ravensbourne. And to explain the award and to announce the winners, would you please welcome Har Smith and Maurizio Giroli.
Happens every year. I'm so short. I probably need a step, but thank you, Maurizio. It's such a pleasure to actually present the award to the incubation for the Incubation Light Awards for our students. They've been really, really inspirational, and it was a really, really tough task. Our judges had a real nightmare deciding, but we've chosen two winners. And it's all about sort of innovation, it's sustainability of their business, but also their passion for their business. So that was quite a key factor as well. So I'll let you hand you over to Maurizio.
Yeah, well, I'm very pleased to announce that the two winners actually are already two stars for two different reasons. One is not here tonight, unfortunately, because he's already working in France and is very pleased to say that, you know, he got the award, but at the same time is not able to be here. So he's very pleased to be part of the incubation for the next year. And his name is Michał Tomasicek. And the other one actually has changed his name already. So, and the winner is Mershad Abbaslu, which now is Marshall Forrest.
Such an honor to stand here in front of everyone from the industry. Ravensbourne is like a nest, and we study for 3 years. We study for 3 years in Ravensbourne, and once we graduate, we go. I personally feel like we need support in business, and I'm very lucky to win this incubation award, to be a part of such a great platform for everyone, creatives. I love creative things, and I love working with creatives. And at this point, I feel like I can actually be a creative and really leave the nest and fly. I really want to thank my partner, Claire, for putting up with way too many projects this year. And I want to love the McIntyre family for being here. Thank you. I would also like to thank Har Smith. Thank you so much for believing in me and giving me the opportunity to be a part of such a great team. And thank you, everyone, and have a lovely night, I guess.
Well, congratulations to Marshall, and well done on your new name, by the way. It's very catchy. Ladies and gentlemen, this year we've also introduced another award. The Distinguished Dissertation Award is awarded to one final year student here at Ravensbourne who's demonstrated the most innovative, unusual, passionate, creative, and critical approaches to the dissertation. A lot of qualities to ask someone of. And I'm very delighted to tell you that Francesca Dunn is our winner. Let's give her a round of applause. Let's take a look at Francesca's work.
I wanted to explore the reasons why the male species seem to dominate the STEM subjects. I wanted an answer as to why I was the only girl on my audio technology course. I needed to determine how this scenario developed, and more importantly, was there anything we could do as a society to change it? The answer to that question is yes. The fundamental reasons as to why there is such a lack of women is all down to society, along with advertising, parenting, and teaching. There needs to be a big change in all these areas if we want to see a future full of females focused on chasing their goals in all subjects that intrigue them. If we continue to support and show young women what they are capable of, then anything is possible. And if you ask me, the future of the next generation looks bright.
For her terrific achievement, well done. Congratulations, Francesca. Now, it's time for another musical interlude, ladies and gentlemen, and this time we have Corey Fox Fardell on his guitar. Ladies and gentlemen, it's Corey Fox Fardell!
It's so much better to be out than in love, and it's so much easier to be free than in touch. It's so much better to be out than in love. Da 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 da. Oh, yeah. Don't feel like landing. I don't feel like landing. Just wanna stay so high. Don't feel like loving. I don't feel like loving you tonight, but you may make me feel like so much so I could die. But it's much better to fall than I have loved at all. What does it hurt so much? Well, did I love too much? Yeah, was I just another cheap date? This man, not just somebody to fall to dust. You gotta ask yourself, you gotta ask yourself the question. Has this love or ink clip both of our wings? Don't feel like landing, I don't feel like landing. Just wanna stay so high. Don't feel like loving, I don't feel like loving. Tonight, but you may make me feel like so much so I could die. But it's much better to fall than I have loved at all.
Ooh. it all.
Thank you. This song is called Complex. Poisoning, you're in my blood and you're a part of me. At least I thought you were. See, God, it's all these things you say.
Fantastic stuff. Well, just before our next award, I've got a bit of business to do here. Got to add my finishing touches to this piece of artwork. Here we go. Sponsored by Bic. I don't know about you, but if I was being sponsored, I think I'd probably choose Aston Martin. Bic, he'll learn. Anyway, talking of learning, ladies and gentlemen, we now move over to the dark side. The dark side, you know what I'm talking about, the dark side, the Broadcast Technology Award. Those people you never see. Nobody knows what the hell they do. They live in the dark side, in the background. I have to be very nice to them, otherwise I'll lose my auto cue. Steve Snook from Gearhouse Broadcast had a look over their engineering excellence. Steve, take it away.
Hello everyone, good evening. My name is Steve Snook. I am the engineering manager for Gearhouse Broadcast UK. And I'd like to thank Ravensbourne for allowing me to judge three projects. And here are the nominees.
Major project is looking at immersive audio, taking binaural audio into an object-based approach and being able to render the direction of the person's head. So as they turn their head, the soundscape moves with them and follows them around.
I'm making an automated follow spot system that motion tracks someone walking across a stage or a studio.
The project was to establish a major broadcasting house in Cairo. I was part of the project management team who actually chose the technology, implemented it, worked through with leader industry providers, and the project is now out and is functioning in Cairo and is broadcasting live.
Ravensbourne's given me the tools to go out and be a successful engineer with a range of disciplines.
See, broadcast tech is changing dramatically in the past few years, from moving from linear TVs to video on demand and interactive services. I think the role that broadcast tech engineers are going to play in the future is going to be very critical.
It looks like broadcasting is going very IP based in pretty much everything. IT systems are slowly working their way into every part of the broadcast chain.
They're going to sort of bridge the gap between the normal TV and the portable devices that everybody is using, allowing more content and allowing more knowledge to be accessible to everybody worldwide.
I'd just like to say this was actually pretty tough, really put on the spot. But there is only one winner, unfortunately, and it's Dan Regan.
Thank you very much. It's really great to win this in your awards show. I'm not used to being in front of the camera, which is why I normally sit behind it, but I've got to thank basically the whole of my year for helping me get this from an idea that seemed impossible to actually making it work. Tim Sampson and Martin Gates for just giving us all the support that we need, and to Student Services for funding the extra money towards the screens. It's really great. Thank you very much. Enjoy the rest of the show.
Well, that's actual Dan. He's directing our show tonight. Now, who's actually running the thing? I've no idea. I can't hear anything. They've all left. Anyway, let's crack on. Let me do something. That's just me buffering. No, I'm so sorry. That was a very bad joke. Congratulations to Dan Regan, of course. It's now time for the Still Image Award. See what I did there? This award showcases students' individual approaches to creating powerful images, demonstrating their technical abilities and artistic flair. Please welcome to the stage course leader of photography, Julian Hawken.
Okay, it's gone away. Thank you, good evening. All I'm going to ask you to do is have a look at the nominees, which they're going to show you on the screen.
My final major project is based on men working in the sex industry, and I'm really, really enjoying the project. It's really exciting. It's great to meet all these new interesting people, and I just basically want to bring an insight into this rarely documented world.
The thing, like photography, it's always coming back, and it's always coming back in, it's always going out. It's a bit like fashion, really. Things go away and then they come back again. And at the moment, a lot of things are documentary style because people can capture things on their phone, on the handheld. But I want to go into a commercial industry. I want to go into an advertising industry, and it's something I'm passionate about outside of photography as well. Sport is my main thing, and I bring the two together, and I feel that you can see in the images that I am passionate about what I've done.
So if I had to choose an image, it would be a before and after portrait I did as part of my final major project, which features a drag queen in and out of drag, so as a boy and then after the transformation. And I guess that summarises my experience, because that shoot was one of the most fun experiences I've ever had in the studio, and being able to pursue my own interests in shooting subcultures such as drag queens really was exciting.
If I could do an image that is enjoyment and also pressure at the same time, then that would be the perfect image.
I designed and produced a book because my primary interest is fashion and production in photography. I cast team members, models from agencies all over London, location scouts, all of the production part.
Be prepared for criticism, and yeah, just go about what you do. And I think if you do that, you'll make a name for yourself.
And I'd never photographed a person before, and straight away I loved it, and I wanted to carry on photographing people, because before I came to university I was scared to, and now it's my favourite thing to do. I feel like excited to leave and do a career in photography.
Okay, so I'm actually standing in for Hugh Turvey, who was the industry judge who's had to go away to deal with some family things. Hugh just gave me a quick briefing to explain that he'd looked at the work thoroughly, carefully, with a lot of consideration, and he was finding it very difficult to distinguish which of the nominees should be the final winners. And his conclusion was that it had to be split, and it's going to be split between Jessica Kelly and Sophie Weston.
Such amazing work. Like,
thanks.
We'd like to thank everyone that supported us, mum and dad, and everybody in this project.
Yeah, just thank you everyone that's helped us and supported us. We really appreciate it, so thank you.
Thank you.
Well, congratulations to our winners. That's fantastic. I suppose the more astute amongst you will have noticed that I've been moving around the building here at Ravensbourne. This is a fantastic building. I'm worn out already. I've been on so many different levels. It's such an interesting building, and it's been designed principally to mimic industry. This is no industry like I know, but I mean, this is a fantastic building. And if this is the industry, I want to be in it, I'll tell you. It is fantastic. Isn't it great? Sure is. Our next award is the contribution to editing and post-production. Now, editing and post-production, everyone. This is the Cinderella Award of the year. These are the unseen heroes and heroines who slave for often hours, days, months in those dark, unseen back rooms, turning pig's ears into pearls. And I'm mixing my metaphors, but you know what I mean. They are really the unsung heroes of TV and film television production. Here to tell us more about this unique black art is the digital editor for BBC Radio 4 and Radio 3, Rhian Roberts.
Hello. I just want to say, first of all, thank you very much, Ravensbourne, for providing me with one of my best moments of the last year, which was walking in to the Director General's boardroom at the BBC with students from the second year here with skateboards under their arms. And that's never really happened before, I don't think, in that boardroom. And then they pitched their ideas for some brilliant animations on a Radio 4 series of British history and weather. And it's been great fun working with them. And it's also been great today to look at the nominations for this award.
Ravensbourne has made me think about an entrepreneurial spirit. In my time at Ravensbourne, I've set up my own business and started thinking more than just my degree and more than just the education and how I can begin to work in the industry.
Since I've been here, I've had a job for the whole 3 years in the industry, so it's given me a good career. My portfolio stands out because I had loads of different pieces, and they're all different, like editing and colour grading, and I feel like I have a wide variety of different material.
I'm focusing heavily on 360 degree video, so I really want to immerse the audience within the content that I'm editing and creating. I feel that 360 video really allows the audience to create memories and empathy with what they're watching. There isn't one leading piece of software, one workflow that really stands out at the moment. So I'm really excited to be involved within this because it's such a learning experience for myself and the others in this kind of industry. My time at Ravensbourne and my thoughts around that really set people up to succeed within their industries.
And the award goes to someone who made me feel sick for an hour after judging this 360 degree VR bungee jumping, Jack Churchill.
So as an editor, I'm going to keep this kind of short and sweet, so I want to get back to my cave. But my mum told me that I need to say thank you to her, so thank you, Mum. Sat back here there. I also want to thank my tutors, especially Caroline, who's got a really kind of immersive experience within VR and is really passionate about that. And then finally, Ogilvy Labs, who have given me the kind of experience to be able to try out this VR and to really thrive within that. So thank you, Nicole, down here. Brilliant. Thank you.
Well, congratulations to Jack, ladies and gentlemen. 360-degree bungee jumping. Ha, that's nothing. I've got my own miniature railway down here, look. They don't pay me any extra danger money for standing here, I have to tell you. There could be a train along any minute. The final... it wasn't bad, was it? The final course award is the Blueprint Award. Now, these are the architects, ladies and gentlemen. I was talking about this fantastic building earlier, and where would we be? We wouldn't have this building, for instance, if it hadn't been for an architect who designed it in their head. And they've been exhibiting their ideas and designs on level 6. Now, Dana Walker from the Stephen Lawrence Charitable Trust took a look around today. So let's now find out what she thought.
Thank you and good evening, everyone. It's an absolute honour to be here on behalf of the Stephen Lawrence Charitable Trust. We actually support students with bursaries. And looking at the work today, we can certainly see that architecture is in safe hands for the future. The four students nominated did an incredible amount of work. It was incredibly close. Why don't we take a look at the nominees?
As soon as I arrived here, I understand that this was the correct place to be. I really enjoy how the architecture of this building is made, how all the classes are mixed up, and how you can always link different knowledge from everywhere.
It allows you to exchange your ideas and communicate with people very easily. And it's also very inspiring that you can go around and look at the people, how they work.
What's it brought to me? I mean, it's taught me to be, you know, very independent, you know, getting stuff done by yourself, working as a team as well.
Really helpful for me to understand the different the different nationalities, different languages, different communities that come bring together the ideas and create the stuff. My final major project is a project for the future. It's giving an answer of the issue of the London flooding. Oh, it's different because it's a master plan project. That gives solution.
I think it stands out because I decided to change the function of the building, which is associated with religious buildings. So I decided to create a brewery because I wanted to change the function of the building from celebrating God into celebrating beer.
I'm designing a boat club in Islington. The area itself and the canal they use is kind of desolate. No one uses the area, and it's such a lovely place, you know. It's lovely, you know, intricate walks between the canals and that kind of stuff. And I thought it would be a really great place to, you know, open up.
And because of the technology, we're gonna use new materials. We can build higher. We can build, probably we're gonna move it even like underwater, like to the oceans. We're gonna be able to have more curvy, sexy buildings.
And for making fantastic use of an existing structure and repurposing a building, knitting the past and the present together, the Blueprint Award goes to Dominika Gozdek.
Very great experience to study at Ravensbourne, and I would like to say thank you to my tutors, to my friends, for the guidance and inspirations. Thank you.
Congratulations to Dominika, well done. Well, that concludes our final award for the courses, but there's still more to come. But first, please will you welcome to our stage Erica.
Thank you.
Stop where you are, don't take another step. You know you shouldn't get too close. You're toxic to me. When you're near me, I can't breathe. Inject me with that fatal dose. Try to resist your loving. Already dear. Already got someone to call my very own. Forget the taste. Deceit is bitter on my tongue. Back in your arms. Did it come to this? I never thought we'd get this far. Try to resist your loving. I came undone. I should be better than this, 'cause love. I thought I found love. Cause after we messed around, turned my whole world upside down, so confused. I thought I found love. Cause after we messed around, turned my whole world upside down.
Warrior, I really am a warrior.
it was a warrior. All I really ever wanted was a warrior. Warrior. Warrior.
Thank you.
Erica, ladies and gentlemen. What an absolutely beautiful song. I think you agree. I'd listen to that all day long. It was fantastic. Thank you so much, Dean. We'll be hearing more from you throughout the rest of the evening, what's left of it. Thank you so much for that. Now, the penultimate, or penultimate, by the way, is the one before the end, all right, just in case you didn't know. I've been to university too. The penultimate award is sponsored by Ogilvy Labs. Yes, get in! The Ogilvy Innovation Award showcases students who have demonstrated the ability to produce industry standard work coupled with exceptional levels of excellence in professionalism, innovation, and ambition. Please welcome to the stage Nicole Yershin, Director of Innovative Solutions within the Ogilvy Group, to talk about this award and present the winner with their award. Nicole, thank you.
Not so easy for me. I don't have auto cue in front of me. So there, I've managed to mess up this award in terms of, I was told these are the people who were the finalists, and I thought, no, I'm sorry, it's just not quite right. So we've split it into two awards. There's one award that's a Teachers Innovation Award for Ravensbourne, and that award, and is a worthy winner, is to Harry Foster. So if you come up, Harry. And before I kind of ask you to say a few words, there was another, when I was going around and seeing what everyone was doing, and I mean, some of the things are just unbelievably inspiring considering how young a lot of them are. But there was one guy that absolutely stood out for me in a true kind of understanding of the word innovation, because lots of people have lots of different meanings to it, but leading edge and new. But it was the fact that he'd spotted a problem, he'd found a solution, he was very passionate about it, and then he made it happen, which is always a bonus because lots of people have ideas and never actually do something about it. And there is a commercial element to what he's done. So he could absolutely sell that into someone and have it so that it was a software product or hardware product that actually could be commercialized upon. And that, for kind of the labs, is true entrepreneurship. And this guy, who doesn't even know that he's won this award, but that is Dan Regan.
Sometimes when you make something that kind of lives on a screen, you think that you don't get recognized. It's not something that somebody can hold. And when you get recognized for something like that, it's really exciting. It's really amazing. And thank you so much for putting me forward for that. So, yeah, thank you.
It's a bit of a surprise from the fact that I wrote the script and I didn't know this award was being presented. So it's a complete honour. Thank you very much for recognising it. I'm really happy with the end result of the project, and hopefully it can be taken forward and we'll see where it ends up. Yeah. So thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you.
Well, congratulations to Harry and Dan. And that is almost it, ladies and gentlemen. We're almost finished this evening. It's time to finish your drinks, but not before. I'm sorry, I haven't gone anywhere. I've just been down the tunnel. Just before we announce the winner of our Student of the Year Award, which used to be known as the Teacher's Pet Award, but I'm sure he or she is anything but. And who better to present it than Linda Drew and president of the Students' Union, Tor, ladies and gentlemen.
Good evening, everyone. I've only got 2 weeks left of my presidency. It's been an incredible year. I would like to thank the TDS team. I think they've done an amazing job. Since I've only got 2 weeks left, I want to do some thanks before my actual speech starts. I want to thank my amazing team, my vice presidents, but I also want to give some special thanks to people who never get them, like Sadi, my co-worker. And I also want to give some special thanks to Louise and Leighton, who's been some amazing mentor to me this year, and I couldn't have done them without them. This is my fourth year at Ravensbourne, and I'm going into my fifth. I'm doing a master's next. And I feel privileged to be able to study at an institution where neither me or my peers don't have to be worried about being judged about their skin color, economical background, faith, or sexual orientation. Ravensbourne is a place where I felt welcome to fully express myself without being worried about being bullied or ridiculed. I strongly believe that I'm not alone with that same experience. Now, as many of you are going into the world of work, I would urge you to take that frame of mind with you and be advocates for openness, inclusivity, and togetherness against the fear that is roaming our streets and news channel. We stand so much stronger together. And now I would like to give over to Professor Linda Drew.
Hey, follow that, eh? And I think you all know, but this year's award has gone to a student who's shown not just great progress and development throughout his time here at Ravensbourne, but this year's Student of the Year award goes to Christopher Chucky.
The Student of the Year Award is important to us because it recognises the students who have shown great progress and development throughout their time here at Ravensbourne. The Student of the Year Award is also important to us because it recognises the student who has contributed to the Ravensbourne student experience and have also improved the community for everybody.
Christopher Chucky is a lovely boy on our course. Three words, he is kind.
To be very hardworking, a very good filmmaker.
Thoughtful and happy, like genuinely happy.
I think you deserve to be Student of the Year because not only are you very talented, but you spread a lot of good energy around the year. So I think you deserve it.
To see you grow from what you were, even like way before Ravensbourne, to like to the stuff that you're achieving now, and like the amount of thought that you put into everything, and.
Wow, thank you so much, everyone. Thank you so much. This is an incredible honor, incredible. Thank you so much, everyone. First, I'd like to thank God. I give him all the glory because without him, I wouldn't be standing here today. Thank you, everyone. Wow, I've been here for 4 years. I did a foundation here, now just finished doing DFP, and it's been an incredible journey. I'd like to thank the team, Bishroka, Tony, Joe and Caddy, Fola and Ola, you guys have been amazing. Like 2 years ago, we made our first major short film and I pitched them the idea and they loved it, but we didn't have enough money to do this. So we all got jobs in the O2, working as stewards, getting paid minimum wage, and we raised £3,000. So these guys, I give them everything. They've been amazing. And Tony, who's my producer, he's just been the rock of the group. He Honestly, he has. He's been the rock. We just finished doing a project, Mockingbird, and a lot of people thought we couldn't do it. We wanted £8,000 on the Indiegogo, and we only managed to raise £2,000. But Tony, who did an incredible job, he managed to raise £20,000 for this project. And it's been, thank you, Tony. It's been amazing. I would like to thank my editor over there, the man himself, Sammy. He's been great. I would like to thank my lecturer, who's just been the best. He's like my film father, Garth. He's been amazing. Thank you. I'd like to thank the rest of the lecturers as well. Andrea, Freddie, Ben, you've all been brilliant. I'd like to thank Amy and Sandy, who've just been organizing our lives. Like, without them, we wouldn't be here. Mum, Dad, my brothers, well, who's somewhere here, who reads all my scripts, all my films, and yeah, he doesn't have a choice, but he did a good job, thank you. Just everyone in Ravensbourne, you've been great. All my friends, wow, it's been incredible. Thank you so much, guys, thank you. Thank you.
Christopher, come here, on your feet. Come on, come out front. Your Student of the Year. Brilliant. Tall and good looking as well. I hate him already. Ladies and gentlemen, wasn't that brilliant? That brings this year's award show to a close, which means, there's only one thing for me to say, it's time to face the after party, ladies and gentlemen. Come on! You've been fantastic. I've been brilliant. What an event. I'm now off to get hammered and jump in the Thames. Come on!
Shows the pain. You tilt your head up, try to kiss it away. You turn my world around tonight. You held me up, you held me tight. Your fears don't have to rule what your heart has to say. The stars will shine tonight. So what are you waiting for? You've gotta hold on like you don't. So what's the point of waiting? What are you hiding from? Tell me, why are you hiding?
Go, Ravensbourne, you did it!
Whoa, whoa, and the skies are burning.